Hi, today I'm going to show you how you can add barcodes to FileMaker. So this is our demo app here, and let me go ahead and just go ahead and show you how this works real quick. So I'm going to add a new product. Instead of entering in the serial number by hand, I want to use my my Bluetooth scanner that I have available. So let me go ahead and I'm going to actually show you what this looks like on the iPad. A little tricky. So this is the device. I'm going to try not to get... So when I scan the barcode, you can see that it added it over here. And once... Oops, I didn't really want to do a search on this side. Once we click Add, and it shows up on our iPad. So, you know, we can always... There's basically two different ways that you can scan items. You can either scan using iOS Go, which is only available on an iPad, which is what this is. So if I click that same button on this side, again, you see this. If I scan that, you'll see I find my product. You can also use the same Bluetooth scanner I just showed you on either the iPad or a Mac. You'll notice that when you pair a Bluetooth scanner, it's going to come across as a keyboard. And what you need to be aware of when you're doing scans and stuff is that you need to be in a field, which is why a Show Custom Dialog works pretty well, because as soon as you scan it, it's going to automatically continue the script, because it adds a return at the end. So that is how I can find it. So that's kind of how you scan, you know, either scanning to populate the serial number or and also a scan to find the product. Now let me go ahead and just dive into the script a little bit and show you how we're actually generating the barcodes. So this QR code is actually coming from Google's API, and there's a few parameters that we need to pass. The chart type is QR, chart size, and then the data here. I'm not entirely sure what that stands for. But this is kind of the basic principle. So all you really need to do is tell it the size of the container, which we're doing 150 by 150, and then the URL number. If you're doing anything like a long text string or something, you're going to want to do get as URL encoded, because anything like an equal sign, a question mark, ampersand is going to screw up this URL. So that's why we do the get as URL encoded, and then all we do is insert from URL. So really simple how that works, and the barcode is almost identical to that. The only difference is you don't have a size. You just have the data and the URL, and there are a few different chart types. 20 is the most common and allows you the most flexibility, so you can look up on Barcode Generator for a few different types if you want to dive into the different types and benefits and stuff. But yeah, so those just insert into here. One thing to be aware of, the difference between QR code and a barcode is obviously this is 3D versus 1D, and one of the biggest differences, the longer this gets, the harder this gets to read for a device, and typically the QR code is still readable because it can store more information. The other thing to be aware of is that this QR code cannot be scanned by a laser scanner. You need a camera of some type, like an iOS device, something like that. So let me go ahead and show you kind of scanning on the iPad side. Let me make this front. So yeah, we can go ahead and scan that. Let's go ahead and find it for us. So yeah, this actually works good on both. So I can also scan the barcode. Works fine on either. Finds the record we're looking for. And so definitely some pros and cons. The Bluetooth scanner is a little bit quicker if you're doing lots and lots of different records you're going to scan. But it doesn't work on a screen. So if someone... You know, if you had someone come up to you with the screen, their phone, and wanted you to scan their device, It's going to work better with the camera. The Bluetooth scanner is not necessarily going to work because it's based on light and the lasers, and it just doesn't reflect properly, and you won't get the right reading. So just a few things to keep in mind when you're developing your solutions. But yeah, fairly easy to implement and gives you a lot of power. So let us know what you think. Thanks.